Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Dark Souls. Last episode, we entered the DLC, Artorias kicked our ass a few times, and then we came back. This episode, we are going to be exploring more DLC, frankly put. No more explanation needed. Although I do think it's interesting that the deeper we go, the more corrupt it seems the area is becoming. So I don't know what that says. Okay. Now this feels like a trap to me, and there are two spellcasters, however, I also remember that elevator, so this should... Shit. Okay, it was a trap, I was... Oh, if I get hit again with that, I'm dead. Come on, get behind cover, and heal. Really? Come on! See, that's what I mean. I died there because the game fucked me over. Like, the enemy hit me, and I actually couldn't move. Like, I was hitting the B button. I was trying to roll away. I was trying to block. And the game actually wouldn't let me do anything. It forced me to die, is what happened there. That is bullshit. That is complete and unadulterated bullshit. That should not have happened. Try to use that fucking key and see what happens. That's right, press key opens this. Oh. So here we have a giant bow. A tower.
Must be the one who freed Artorias, that old friend. He left this world with honor, and here I am, retired, a little help.
So we can buy stuff from him. So he sells the usual stuff. Ah, but he sells great arrows.
Dragons, we knights fought valiantly. Upon every one of them, exhilaration, pride, hatred, thou will understand. At our twilight, old thoughts as very... What good is a dog with no hares to hunt? But I'm lucky to be alive. Farewell, you. Lead thy life.
So that is Gog. He is the one that actually made the stuff. The carvings. And he's blind, which actually does make sense why he would carve them. Although, how did he carve them with expressions? Let's see. Weird. Whatever. Well, anyways, now I have to redo all that fucking progress again. And I was so close to. That is. Which means, like. And I mean, you guys, as the viewers, I'm probably going to cut this out so you don't have to watch it. But, like, I have to redo all that progress now because the game fucked me over. It's just frustrating that I died because the game glitched out, not because I screwed up. Like, I'm being punished because the game didn't work, is basically the way that I see this. Is that really what happened? Well, not really, but, I mean, it's true enough to cause... Yep, so come here. Wow, that curves fast. Like, so you can't avoid it unless you time the invincibility roll just right. And if you don't block it, and if you don't roll just right, it'll just kill you. That is so unfair. is there a quick way down? Appear to be. I just gotta be forced to fight all these guys. No, that's not true, because if I can get over to there... But that means I have to also bypass this area. It's doable. It's not impossible, but it's still... Where the fuck did you come from? That's who I wanted to run from. This will allow us to drop down to here. Hopefully without triggering all the guys inside to just come tearing ass after me. Okay, one of them came out. That's actually fine. And like, I know this is what the game is doing, is it's trying to force me to... Now at least I know the dark orbs are going to be incoming. So I have to trigger that. Shit. This is what killed me last time. Heal, please. Thank you. So it does look like that sorcerer is now coming after me, which is good. So if I move out of line of sight, the sorcerer will come closer and I can actually hit him without triggering the other's physical fighters. Okay, so that means that my package was delivered. Yep, so he actually did walk forward like an idiot. However, I think that's another sorcerer right there. There's an NPC right there. Or... Shit. Okay, this is really bad again. No, I'm not gonna record this anymore. I'll see you guys after I clear this bridge. I don't know how many takes it's gonna take, so I'll see you. There, I died two more times trying to get down here, just... The game blocking when it... Like, I'm rolling and I'm being hit in the middle of the roll and a couple of other shit factors, but... I'm here, so I don't know where this... what this thing is. What the hell are you? Guarding a shortcut, so that makes sense. He's moving forward too fast. He's looking weird. Looks interesting. Interesting character. Oh boy. Okay. god, but okay. This is the abyss. It's gotta be. You can see there are items down there. Chasm of the abyss. No, I'm not gonna be stupid and chase you. Well, I mean, I will if you're not gonna go far. Okay, I see the red eyes, so... There's more than one of you. What the heck? Piece of shit. Okay. What that was. Good though. Yeah, you laugh. But you realize I'm going to kill you now. I do want to see what the bloated head is used for. Whose humanity went wild. Sane person would have. Mead. So apparently these are just going to be a bunch of hexes. Need to charge my phone too. For some reason my phone is stuck like an hour behind too. Sorry about that. I am trying to remember to do that. Alright, not seeing any... This area is lagging pretty bad. Just glad I have the sunlight maggot. This would be so annoying. Humanity. That is just humanity. Those are actually enemies. Is that water? That's not water, is it? I don't want to know what that is. Oh boy, there's a lot of you. First time that you can do this game on TV. So my TV is now saying that there is no signal. Even though I can clearly see there is, it is still a signal, but the TV is thinking that there is not. So it is now stuck, this giant fucking thing on my screen. Okay, they seem to be catching me at some break though, so I'm gonna, literally when that happens, I just pull the HDMI plug and put it back in. And it works just fine. Like, from that point on. Did the game crash? Okay. You got humanities. That's what I thought. Now, you guys are aware of me, though, so I really don't want to just leave you alone. Ow. Whoops. I didn't mean to come down here. That was the cat. Who was a trusted friend of... I actually don't think I showed that, so I'm gonna show that now. If you look at the cat ring, it actually says, trusted friend of Knight Artorias and the Great Wolf Sif. So when she said that there was nobody there, it is actually heavily implied, or that Artorias' grave doesn't exist. It is actually heavily implied that she is lying to you to protect the grave of Artorias. Clearly she wants us to follow. Okay, so there's something over here, but I'm going to keep following her. This would be a good place to farm humanity, so... Okay, I don't see her. So where she was trying to lead us must have been to here. Oh, is this the shortcut? Starting to make a little bit more sense now. So where was Alva leading us to? Alright, I'm coming back, Alva. Chasm of Abyss. Sorry, I didn't mean to run away, Alva. She disappeared around here. Doesn't seem to be anything down, and there was a clue to just drop down before, so I suspect if she was there, we would see her outline, so that leads me to believe, because she didn't just, like, she was over here, so, like, that leads me to believe that there's an illusion. illusionary wall. Okay, and we see a glowing circle of something. Luckily, my lightning seems to do just fine, so just keep using this. So they're just treated as darkness damage. Now that may look, explosives in case it accidentally hurts. The pumper's over there may look familiar. And he should. That is the Great Wolf Sif. Of course, slightly younger, but... it's to be expected. We're all going to go back in time, so... But if you wanted to know what Sif looked like when she was, when he or she was up Diddle Poppers, this is what she looked like. So if we go over and rescue Sif, he or she will howl, and the ring will disappear. And if we pick it up, it is the Cleansing Great Shield. This is the item that I was going to try to switch to. The Cleansing Great Shield is Artorias' Great Shield. Oh, it only does 80% physical resistance? Oh, that's really fucking good, though. 80% magic resist, 80% fire resist, and 70% lightning resist. That's really good. More importantly, though, if we look at it, we can see the shield itself is actually pretty messed up. What happens is, I'm not going to use this shield. I didn't know it did that low of a resistance. I like having 100% physical resistance, but we have now rescued Sif. We freed Sif. It is implied that Artorias, it's not implied, it actually said. Artorias, well, actually, you know what? Let's check the fucking shield. Yep, the great shield used by Artorias, who succumbed to the Abyss, deeply scarred by the Abyss, used this to form a barrier to protect his compatriot, Sif. Although this drained the shield, its magic defense remains high. So the shield itself was actually used by Artorias to protect Sif. That is why when Artorias went down... well, Artorias went down, and so that's ultimately what happened, is Sif was protected by Artorias' shield, though from the look of the shield, it wouldn't have lasted too much longer before it broke. So Artorias was actually being corrupted by the Dark, and so what is happening is the Abyss is corrupting him thoroughly. So we need to save him. And we actually did. We slayed Knight Artorias. So we've already killed Artorias. Where are you?
The soul of the man who fell on this spot? He was a dear friend. I wish to pay proper respect with that soul. Would you be willing to part with it?
I actually don't know what this does. Let me check. Well, you guys are gonna see, because I don't know what this does, and... oh, one of Gwyn's four knights, only female member, lays waste to Gwyn's enemies through assassination and subterfuge. Given her dialogue and the hornet ring is found behind Artorias' grave on a female corpse, she may have been very close to the fallen knight, possibly had romantic feelings. Gives you the gold tracer and the dark silver tracer for the soul of Artorias. Oh. Okay, so only give it to her if she does, if you don't plan on killing her. Okay, so what does the soul of Artorias give us? So we can craft the Abyss Greatsword. Okay, so what's the gold tracer and the silver tracer then? Ah, I see. So, technically, we could just kill her, I guess. So this playthrough, I think I will.
Thank you. Please take this. May the Lord guide thee.
So I could kill her, but I'm not going to. I do want to check what these tracers do. Okay, there's the gold tracer. 130. What is it? Wow, 25 dex, no kidding. Okay, so that explains that dialogue. And she built a monument to Artorias. That would also explain why she asked for Artorias's soul. She wanted to honor his memory. And if she did have romantic feelings for him. That also implies heavily the two that the fact she is a knight and she gave up her sword to us. So that implies to me that when she gave up her soul, she did so know or her sword, she did so knowing that she would never. Like, she's basically ending her life. Her life is considered over. She's never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. So that's interesting. And yes, I know I could kill her. I really don't want to though. Just she wanted to honor Artorias. And honestly, I like Artorias a lot. Artorias is one of my favorite characters of Dark Souls 1. Well, I say one of. I do really like Artorias, but I think Sif and there's a couple of other ones that are just really awesome that I really, 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 really. But that asshole over there still rubs me the wrong way. I don't like him. It's not this one, it's this one. So we rested at the bonfire, and we did that. So now we should be able to be strong enough to take on Manus. Oh, right, I have to kill all these shorts. So you see me. So this leads to an item. Okay. And to a sorcerer. Okay. Oh boy. Okay, so where did down go then? Does that lead to another item then? Maybe not. Let's find out. So there's a lot of shit down here. Very interesting that the choice of humanity is both light and dark. Like, it does make them very obvious to see. So humanities can never sneak up again. I believe these are called corrupted humanities as well. I don't know, just I really like this character design. Or man, anyway. So Finally, we get a pyromancy spell. A spell I can use. So that was well worth coming over here. Oh, now we run back up here and then go up this way. Although I will admit, I do like how they're using the glowing pebbles to tell you, hey, this is where you are supposed to go. That is very helpful. And then I guess it's just a drop down? Yes, it is. Okay, so I think that's the giant mass of humanity, so we're kind of backtracking here. Although I do want to check and see if there's items. I don't really want to either, so let's just go down here. Switch into this, because I have a feeling this is going to lead to the boss. Or we're going to be very close to said boss. There doesn't appear to be anything extra, so let's go into the black hole. Ooh, funky. Okay, well now we know where the boss is. Soul of a hero. Oh joy. So helpful. Thank you much. Okay, there definitely is something down there. Oh shit. Yeah, I don't know what that is, but that looks terrifying. Well, let's go into the fog gate and say hi. Uh-oh. Mordo the human grabbed us again. Ugh. So that's what the heck is this arm. For, you know, for him being the pygmy. Okay. So, according to what I saw, looking for Sif's summon sign, because Sif is able to be summoned in the air. Unfortunately, with the shit kicking I've been getting, I saw it, and then I lost. There it is. I need to heal. Come on. Move, move, move. Fucking piece of shit. You're not gonna give me the chance to summon. I'm Great Grey Wolf Sif. So if you manage to free Sif, Sif will actually help you in this fight. And Sif, I don't know if Sif is helpful in this fight. Some NPCs are really good, some NPCs are really bad. How he's moving though, I'm gonna easily be able to get him. If you want. me a hand here, buddy? Why did I take damage there? So similar to the boss fight with Sif, if Sif takes too much damage, Sif will start blocking. Unfortunately, I don't think Sif is going to survive this one. Just don't do enough damage. I was really hoping Sif would survive, but I don't think Sif is going to make it to the end. Manus is just too strong. Too strong, please nerf. I'm doing pretty good though. I'm doing better than I thought I would. I am aware that if you roll, there's a chance you can get up before the enemy, like, registers it. The only issue with that is when you roll, like I've shown before, well, as you guys have seen, the game actually does have that, like, okay, you physically can't dodge that. You are just going to get nailed every time that happens. The game has a delay, like, to the point where it, why am I even trying to dodge that? Where if you do roll, it, like, the game doesn't register that you rolled, until after you actually get up. So there's a huge delay there, and you can't cancel that animation. So, yeah, that just killed me. So. Okay, I'm gonna do the fight with Manus one more time. If I die again, I'm just gonna stop recording it. Oh, I could have used the silver pendant on that fight, and that would have actually done it. Okay, I don't think I need to worry about it now. I had forgotten about the silver pendant. I can handle it now, but I do need to rekindle so I can sift to give me a hand again. I also wonder if divine weapons would work better, but I don't know, and I kind of don't want to equip a lesser weapon just on the off chance that it might. I could check, but I was doing okay there. My biggest problem was, is Sif wasn't really, like, Manus was focused on me, which was causing the problems. She's still here? She's not, she moved. She did leave a flower. She also left her hair? Interesting. There are some cultures where, or there's some, I don't know if it was an anime or if it was an actual culture, but where a warrior was required to shave their hair, like their ponytail, if they lost. And so, like, if she left her hair, it's possible that this particular female knight also followed the same thing. So she died, or her lover died, Artorias, and so she's given up her knighthood, and the result is she is now done. So she cut off her ponytail. Just an interesting little fact that may or may not be. Okay, now I'm going to do this so it goes back up. And similar to before, I am not going to fight the humanities. I'm just going to run through them. Because I know what you guys are doing, and I am not here to fight you guys. I am going to fight you, though, because you're a fucking asshole. This area is lagging me out pretty good. So, that's actually not too bad of a run. Still do like how you can see the guy, see Manus's eyes down there staring at you. Oh, there were my symbols too. Yep, come on. Grab me again. Let's also see if I can summon Sylph before I get my shit kicked in too much. I know the summon sign is around here, I just don't know. Oh, I see. I'm probably gonna get killed. Jumping to win. Shit, I lost it. Oh. like I said, it's just, you've already seen everything, so I'll see you guys when we fight soon. Okay. Just beat Manus, Sif howled, and then disappeared. Now, we light the bonfire. And I actually think the DLC is done. I don't think there's anything else we can do here. No, that can't be right. Okay, I'm gonna check the DLC just to make sure. No, I do not want to check the entrance. Additional content, here we go. Oh, there's the dragon that I can fight. I forgot about that. No, I did not want the guardian. Sold by... Oh! Okay. Oh, so you can get the armor bait. Okay. Okay. So that's where that is. Yeah, so the DLC is not quite over yet. We still have to go to... Is it the township? Is it the township dungeon? I think it's the because it's not the sanctuary, so that makes me think it's the township. I was correct. It was the township. So yeah, I wasn't aware that I was supposed to do this. It still took a couple of tries to get the timing down right, but that being able to completely negate his dark attacks really, really fucking helped. A couple of my deaths were because I actually didn't trigger it fast enough, and so I accidentally killed myself using it. Okay, I don't think we're gonna need the sunlight maggot for where we're going, so I'm gonna pop the Mask of the Child back on. And let's talk to him after since we killed Manus. Nothing new. Okay.
So long.
I don't like you, though, so... What do you say we kill him? Shit.
Oh, it's come to blows, has it? Fine, then. I've had enough of you anyway.
Whoa, what did you throw, buddy? Okay, I know this has to be a reference to something. Unfortunately for you, I am quite a good pyromancer. Oh! Wow, he actually killed me!
You dumb fool. I am Marvelous Chester. What did you expect?
Okay, there we go. Well, I know I'm gonna I'm gonna fuck you up as soon as I get back there. Okay, let's go. It was the township. Township, right? Was it the township dungeon? Fuck! No, it was not the dungeon. It's this one. And this time, I'm going to blast you with fire, chaos fire magic from the start. Marvelous Chester. You don't really sell anything that I want, and so there's no reason to keep you alive. And I don't like you, unlike the knight that was in love with Artorias. So you're just gonna shoot me from here? Okay. If that's a four-hit combo, that would have killed me. Like, just flat out. That's end of the bite. Haha. Okay. Good to know I'm invincible here. Hey, buddy. Hi. Got a fireball with your name on it. Original, are you? Attacks all kind of cycle through the same movements.
You win, please.
Oh, please.
Nah, you died. Yes, so you do get his stuff. Where the fuck did he come from? Because his armor does not look like anything we've seen in Dark Souls. And on top of that, like, the snickering top hat, like... Curse of Chester. Aristocratic coat, move in silence, lending well to stealth. And it looks like there's a medicine bag here. I wonder if he came from the future, like... possibly from Bloodborne, perhaps? I don't know. It would be an interesting concept, for sure. I've still got some spells. So let's go take on the dragon, see if we... Well... Let's go back to the bonfire, save, and then go take on the dragon. This is gonna be a nightmare to edit. I've got, like... Because I've been cutting so much. Like, that's why I was actually using the screen... The shadow play function, so I could do just all one long recording, but... Because I've been cutting and pasting so much, like, it's gonna be a pain to figure out which goes with what episode. And I'm gonna level up, too. Something's come out of here. Dion's a yes, and I have 30 vitality. A lot of health. Oh, shit. It's also 3:25, so I've gotta... I have to be at work at 5, so I still need to take a shower. And I've gotta get ready to go, so this will be my last... episode of the day. Oh shit. I don't want to go. The ramp's over there. So the dragon's probably gonna kill me. I'm not expecting to beat the dragon on my first try, so if I do die, I'm not gonna show the fight. I'm just gonna do it either off-screen, or I won't do it at all. I don't know. Whoopers! Poopers! My poopers is called Sif. My poopers is a giant wolf that knows swordplay. To this world was over here, so I'm half wondering, like... Oh, okay. Oh, that's a treasure chest over there. Can I walk in this? Will this kill me? I don't think they're dicking, they're gonna pull a dick move, but I don't know for sure, so. They pulled a dick move. Oh god, it's coming back. Oh, attack next. While helpful, not particularly useful. Let's go see if we can get those items, so I can show what those are at least. This one has words in front of it, so I assume Soul of Great Warrior. This one is directly Son of a Hero. Sight of the naked god. Yeah, I wonder if it's using darkness. I knew the dragon was going to kill me, but apparently I can't fight him, so we're going to call it quits here. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I will see you guys in the next episode, where we will be getting back on track, and we will be going to fight Great Wolf Sif again. So, see you then!